doing this for Raila. I want to say that even on the 25th, when we occupied Parliament, even Raila himself did not know we were going to do it. So this has never been about Raila. It will never be about Raila. This movement has been about the people, the common mwananchi. Raila just took an opportunity kuingiza watu wake kwa cabinet, kwa hiyo CS positions. And when we throw these people out tomorrow, he will also be ashamed, because atashanga kwa nini, why did he have to broker hiyo deal? Why did he have to do it? Innocent people have been killed, but walienda nyuma yetu wakaelewana, and they took advantage of our goal. So going forward, I believe this has never been about Raila. This has been about bad governance, and he is part of it. Everyone else is part of it. All these politicians, and this is why me spend the politicians attack with these spaces. Why? These people, they just find loopholes, wanataka ku take advantage of it. Wanakuja hapa, wanajifanya, ni kama, you the people should continue, you are doing the good thing. Let me tell you, any other politician, mwenye anajifanya on the side of the people, ingekuwa ni yeye alikuwa amepewa hiyo job ya CS, wangezichukua. They might lie to you here that wangezichukua. Those people would not blink a second, would not even think twice kuchukua hizo kazi wangekuwa amepewa. Wangekuwa mito kwa hiyo negotiation table, they would have taken those jobs. So politicians have never been for the people. They will never be. So tomorrow we are going to the streets, and we the people shall prevail. Tutakonka. We will win this war. Now watu wote watakuwa ashamed from Raila to everyone else. So we are going to drain the swamp tomorrow. Kila mtu, hata ama CS wapi, hao wote wataenda nyumbani tomorrow. They will not believe. Yeah. Mkenya, vipi?
Yes. Hi. Nasikika your side.
Unasikika vizuri sana ndugu yangu.
Asante sana. Yes, one thing, mimi sirudi shida zenye tuko nazo, na hiyo nimekuwa nikiwakumbusha. Sishindi nikiwaambia what we are, hizo ni mashida zenye tunajua. So mimi ni about tomorrow na vile tumejipanga kesho. The other thing is ni a very small activity. So kuna ukiingia kwa kusearch ama kwa kuexplore on your phone, utaona hizo trend in hashtag, utaona hiyo ya hiyo imeandikwa 88 called off. Naomba tu click hizo three dots. Ukiklik hizo three dots, report that hashtag as this trend is harmful or spammy. The reason why we are doing this, they are not going to be ahead of us in any way, and there is no way they are ever going to be ahead of us. You get, as long as is technologically, the brains, constitutionally, every people, we have all the people on board. So one thing we are going to make sure, hata nimeshare hapo kwa Jumbotron, so it's a very short exercise to make sure that when we are communicating, hakuna anything that is interfering with our hashtag and everything. So kindly ingia tu pale, finye hizo three dots in front of that hashtag ya 88. Nataka tu iyeke kama it's a spammy hashtag. That's hiyo ndo kitu yenye nilikuwa nataka kukumbusha. So guys, naambia, keep on the mobilization and I'm happy, like everyone who is doing the mobilization. The other thing is, if you want to support all the people, any comrades wenye watakuwa kesho, whether with flags, placards, anything other fair na nini for the mobilization, ingia kwa DM ya Kioti Songo or my DM, and we support those people who will be coming tomorrow, and let's keep up the mobilization. Sahi tu ni time ya mobilization, hakuna kitu ingine. Education ni presence peke yake. Tuko na only one assignment, unaamka, unaenda CBD, ukienda CBD, si wote una collect pale, around saa nane, tutakuwa State House. Tutapandia hapo tuende State House. So that's the only assignment you have. Hakuna kitu ingine. Online hakuna strategy. Hapa tu ni kuongea na kujipanga, venye kesho tutatokea. Nothing else. Your presence is the strategy. Thank you. Hiyo ndio tulikuwa nataka tukukumbusha.
Thank you, Mkenya. Thank you. Actually, tumebaki na kitu kama 3 hours. All I want to hear tu ni watu kujisaika. Hakuna strategy venye Mkenya amesema. Watu wajisaika, tujue kesho watu tao, nani anatokea, nani atokei, and kama unatokea. Na ikuwe mapema asubuhi, bidika mute your mic. Yeah, so ikuwe mapema na asubuhi sana, tufike tao pale, tuanze kujipanga, tuingie State over na, eh? Pengine ndio chance yako ya pekee kuingia State House. Anyway, aha. Niko na nani? Big Dog. Big Dog Pato.
Oh yes, thank you, thank you. Can you hear me?
Yes, loud and clear.
Okay, so thank you. I'm Patrick, and I come from a place called Keno in Murang'a County. And tonight I'll talk on three things. So first, I know someone, or maybe there before, someone had talked about the dark thread of personality. And actually, if you look at what Ruto has been doing, is that he has shown to be a Machiavellian, a narcissist, and also as a psychopath. And the reason as to why I can comfortably say this is because one thing about the Machiavelli, some of the Machiavellian, is that they are obsessed with power. And actually they can do actually anything to obtain that power. And the reason as to why I say this is that when they see that the odds are against them, you get to see that they use now their religion, or even maybe these mikutanos, paying people to applaud them, as a way of trying to control people. That's their major tool of control. And you've seen that even after he's in power, whenever something goes wrong, the first people to call, not the big minds of Kenya, but the church leaders, you see. And also on the aspect of narcissism is that he's very manipulative. And actually this is what has, actually he fooled us to vote for him. And and you see that even a few months after he gained the power, he turned his back on us and said,
you see, the boda people, the blue economy are not paying tax. So you see that these are part of
manipulative as a tool to your power. And also the aspect now on psychopathy is that you've seen how even after we've lost our dear comrades, he shows no like remorse or even empathy, because I believe when people are obsessed with power and their focus is on the money, that's they don't feel what we feel down here, because you get that person like Ruto, you know, even having lost like 6 people in a day, he's talking of only losing one. And people are killed in Githurai. He tends to seem like he has no idea and only says that property was destroyed. And so these are all now the traits in a dark triad. Then on to the second thing I would like to say is that is the aspect of people saying that we don't have people who can lead, that they are the only people who can lead. I will tell you of something that I overheard or I saw. There's one guy, I got it as a story because he graduated a year before I graduated. And although he was in now KU, but me, I schooled in the Baraton. So this guy, actually, he has a first class honors in engineering. And you know what happened? This guy was taken by now the Japanese to go and run. He was actually given a scholarship and also given a company to run. And here what we have in Kenya is that a son to a person who is in power is given the docket of engineering or development, who had a pass. Who had a pass, not leave alone even second class, a pass. Huyo ni kama mtu alipata hii kwa shule, high school, and a whole ministry, or even maybe the power to be innovative. But you see, yeah, so this is something we can really talk about, because we need young leaders. And I know with what we are doing, we continue pushing like this, the people who will emerge, who we will see are good leaders. And then the other thing is that with my region where I come from, is that the trend I've seen with the previous years, that you see whenever it was, I observed this during the BBI initiative thing, whereby leaders came, especially now people who were supporting Ruto, they came, bought people like 1,000 and buying them nyama choma at Golden Pump so that they can vote against the BBI. So